Hello, thank you for the patience. The marketing, there is an approach. People say that if you come sell your idea in the elevator for 3 minutes, for example, it's not working. I feel really privileged that I don't have only 3 minutes. But I'll try to be as fast as possible. So my name is Petrina Petrova. I'm not Petrova, but Petrova. I'm an economist, and I have more than 20 years in the NGO sector. As an economist, I observed public policies, and in one moment I realized a few years ago that when we speak about the policies, we are all the time observing and monitoring things on macro level. This macro level, however, doesn't influence and impact human beings' lives. And in countries like Bulgaria, usually the money, they don't go directly to people, and they don't result in good practices, and they don't affect regular people's lives. So I decided to support organizations like the Ideas Factory Association. This is a Bulgarian NGO. People there, they are trying to create connections and to fill gaps between and among different groups. They fill gaps between cities in the gaps that are related to lack of not luck, but different levels of development between the cities and big cities and the rural areas. They are making connections between administration and local people. We are very happy that the project which I will present you now will be part of Baltic 2019, our European Capital of Culture, for the next 2 years, this year, 2018 and 2019. Baba Residence is the project that I present now. Right now in Bulgaria, we are facing some serious problems that are related with some disproportion. One of the examples which I can give you is that big cities, they receive a lot of money, and the rural areas, they are suffering of a lack of any investments there, and related also to the public investments there. For example, the Plovdiv budget for this year is 6 times less than the budget of Sofia, which is the capital, and maybe it's normal, but if we want to close the gaps, then we have to invest more money in rural areas and projects there. From other side, the young people in Bulgaria, they face many problems. Somehow they feel lost because school and university system is not well developed. It's not linked to the labor market, and it is they don't receive enough options to obtain social skills, and in this way, they somehow feel disconnected from the reality. They can't deal with the reality as it is now. Our solution is called Baba Residence. Why Baba Residence? Baba in Bulgarian means granny. Our grannies are some special race of human beings because they are good-hearted people. They can feed you, they can take care of you, they can wash your laundry, and mostly they will always love you. And whatever you can do, they'll feel somehow protective to you, and they can accept anything from you. The good thing with the tricky thing with our grannies is that they have this behavior not only to their own grandchildren, but they have this attitude to any child or any person they can accept as their grandchild. And if some of you, nevertheless of the age, go to a Bulgarian village, because our countryside the grandmothers are even better than the city's grandmothers. So then there they will accept you, and they'll take care of you as they take care of their own grandchildren. So that's why we decided to pay particular attention in our villages, and especially in the depopulated villages, because we have many depopulated villages in Bulgaria. Especially in the border areas of the south and in the west, there are whole areas which are depopulated with no people there, or we have villages which are with number of population between 1, 2, 3 people up to 8 people. So we decided to go there and to establish some sort of small communities that can interact and approach their problems. How we make it? Usually the process starts with two application, two selection processes. From one side we select the young people who are eager to go in the villages, and from other side we select municipalities, that small municipalities through their mayors, which want to be part of our Baba Residence. Usually we use our colleagues that are representatives of local organizations in order to assure that process will go smooth in these villages, and will have better access to the local people. Then all participants that are accepted in our program go through a very intense training program where we train them in soft skills. They understand how important and how to behave as team members, as well as team leaders. They learn how to prioritize and how to think out of the box as well, if they can. Then the training phase is followed by the actual residence, which is about 1 month. We usually send groups of between 5 and 10 people in one village, because we find it very useful if we send less people. Somehow they can be lost among the community, and they can't create a real change there. After the, actually when they are in the, within the community, they live there, they speak and discuss with the community many things, and they have the main target to find some sort of solution for social problem or for economic problem. So many of the young people and the teams there, they come up with some very good ideas that we later develop together with them. When they go out of the co-design with them their ideas to support them. So our mentors work with these young people. This was actually the way how I entered this project. I was first mentor, second year residence of Ideas Factory. And after this third phase is done, the final ideas become part of our crowdfunding activities. We organize crowdfunding campaigns, we present the ideas, and usually we succeed to find some small amount of money, at least to some initial start. Our results are, of course, these ideas that young people and old people, the whole community, come up with. Part of the residents develop their original business ideas, but actually, all the ideas they go in our social innovator incubator, where they are further developed. And later on, we just support them their realization. But actually, the main outcome of this project is the quality of human interaction. Bridget was speaking about this, how important is the quality of communication, the quality, how interact among us. And I think that this is something we really need in our societies. So these are a few photos from our last meetings. Actually, the project started in 2015. We had already 3 years and 8 villages that we sent residents. And we have some sort of eight projects and 3 social enterprises were created as a result of this. Thank you very much.